Hello and welcome to the video lecture series. In today's lecture, we will see one of the most prominent method in numerical analysis called Adams-Bashford predictor and Adams-Moulton corrector method. Basically, this method consists of two parts. One is predictor, another is corrector. I will shortly call these two methods as AB and AM. These methods are multi-step methods. We have seen in previous lecture, what do we mean by multi-step methods? Multi-step methods are basically using previous number of approximations which are more than one. Now before we dwell into further workaround of this method, let's see that how this method arises and what is the application. So application of such kind of methods is quite huge. For example, linear multi-step methods, there are various multi-step methods, and this is one class where we are working with linear multi-step methods. So basically, linear multi-step methods are used for numerical solution of ordinary differential equations. Conceptually, a numerical method starts from an initial point and then takes a short step forward in time to find the next solution point, right? The process continues with subsequent steps to map out the solution. Single step methods such as Euler's method refer to only one previous point and its derivative to determine the current value, right? And hence it is called single step method. Whereas methods such as Runge-Kutta take some intermediate steps, for example, a half step, to obtain a higher order method, but then discard all previous information before taking a second step. Okay, and hence this is called a half step method. Whereas in multi-step methods, we will attempt to gain efficiency by keeping and using the information from previous steps rather than discarding it. Got it? Consequently, multi-step methods refer to several previous points and derivative values. In the case of linear multi-step methods, a linear combination of the previous points and derivative values is used. Okay, so basically we are going to use multi-step methods and its linear combinations with the previous points, right? Now let's see, there are numerous papers worked out on such methods. Like you can see, this is the paper published in this journal Computers and Mathematics with Applications in 2010, which was basically deliberating the full value of Adams-Bashford and Adams-Moulton methods and how you are implementing these methods for solving Riccati equations. Riccati equation is very well known equation, very famous equation in the section of differential equations. Secondly, this is another paper that I have found in 2016, where you can say the application of Adams-Bashford and Adams-Moulton methods in fractional analysis, an application to the fractional Keller-Siegel chemotaxis system. So this is another application you can see here. And recently, just before few months, this is another paper came into picture, that is interval methods of Adams-Bashford type with variable step sizes. Now see, this is rigorous study based upon Adams-Bashford method, and hence you can say that this method is live currently also, that you can study this method in detail, you can even analyze some more steps, you can even have some more research in this field, and hence you can say that this is really a burning field. You can give your full output and you can work with full potential, and you can study various options on the basis of these methods. So you can say that in one line, this method is quite useful. Let's begin with that, how to derive the predictor and corrector formulae. So the basic outline is, in the case of Milnes method, if we recall, then we have used Picard's method to get predictor formula and Simpson's rule to get character formula, right? So Picard for predictor and Simpsons for character. Okay, next is, in this method Taylor series or RK method is used. Okay, so Taylor series or RK method is used in combination with Newton's backward interpolation formula for obtaining predictor. Okay, and recurring uses of Newton's backward interpolation formula for obtaining character formula, right? So once you are done with Taylor series or the application of RK method, you are done with the predictor part, then character part is quite easy. You just need to use the recurring application of your Newton's backward interpolation formula to get the refined result. Now let us see what is the basic setup here. So you will be given an initial value problem like dy by dx equal to fxy and y at x naught is equal to y naught. We find y suffix minus 1 which is equal to y x0 minus h. Similarly, y minus 2 is y x0 minus 2h, y minus 3 is y x0 minus 3h by using Taylor series or RK method. Okay. So basically, if you recall that we were working with tables, so basically in this pattern we will follow, right? So y0, y minus 1, y minus 2, y minus 3. Okay, so let's see. Now this implies immediately that f minus 1 is equal to f x naught minus h comma y minus 1. Basically the relation f minus 1 is nothing but f x 0 minus h and y minus 1. Similarly for minus 2 you will have x naught minus 2h and y minus 2. If you want to work with f minus 3, it is same as f evaluated at x naught minus 3h and y minus 3. Now step 1. To find y1, we will substitute in Newton's backward interpolation formula. We will substitute Newton's backward interpolation formula in this expression. Okay. So to find y1, what we are going to write? Y1 is y0 plus integration x0 to x0 plus h fxy dx. Now this fxy is basically this equation number 1. What is this equation? It is nothing but Newton's backward interpolation formula. Okay, so just plug in this formula here and integrate term by term. Now simplify this integral and neglect the higher order terms to get the desired predictor formula. Let's see how we will get this predictor formula, right? So from above two equations we can write y1 equal to y0 plus this integral x0 to x0 plus h which is same as x1, then f0 plus n nabla f0 plus n into n plus 1 by 2 nabla square f0 plus n into n plus 1 n plus 2 divided by 6 nabla cube f0 plus and so on dx. Okay, so this is where we have substituted our nbif. Basically this is my nbif. Okay, so I have substituted nbif, and then the next step is substitute x equal to x0 plus nh. This implies dx equal to hdn, quite obvious. And when x equal to x0, n equal to 0. When x equal to x0 plus h, n will be 1. So in this integral, if you substitute this one, then what you will get? You will get y1 equal to y0 plus h integration 0 to 1. F0 plus n nabla f0 plus n into n plus 1 divided by 2 nabla square f0 and so on. Now this is integral from 0 to 1, so you can simply integrate it. So you will get y1 equal to y0 plus h into f0 plus 1 half nabla f0 plus 5 by 12 nabla square f0 plus 3 by 8 nabla cube f0 and so on. So basically this is nothing but an integral with respect to n. Please keep in mind, so this is basically a variable here. Instead of x, you can see here this is n, right? And hence you will get these terms. So this is quite important for you. Okay, neglecting fourth and higher order terms here and substituting the corresponding functional values here. We are familiar with the definition of nabla. So nabla f naught is equal to f1 minus f0, and similarly you have also derived these relations in past. So use these all relations, nabla f0, nabla square f0, nabla cube f0, and then substitute here. So what you will get? You will get this equation number 3, that is y1, which is equal to y1 predictor, which is y0 plus h by 24 into bracket 55 f0 minus 59 f minus 1 plus 37 f minus 2 minus 9 f minus 3. Okay, so basically you need to remember these formulae, or otherwise you can simply calculate this whole workout, and then you will get these terms, right? So this is what I have obtained as my predictor formula. This formula is known as Adams-Bashforth predictor formula. Next step, now we want to find the corrector formula. So we now use the output of step 2, that is equation number 3, in Newton's backward interpolation formula again, to find the corrector formula. For that purpose, we will find f1 by using y1 from above equation 3, and then substitute the same in Newton's backward interpolation formula, right? So basically what we are going to do now, once we have derived Adams-Bashforth predictor formula, then you can work out easily the value of Newton's backward interpolation formula by using y1. Okay, so basically this is my y1, and I am going to use this now in NBIF to find the corrector formula. Let's see how. We know that the function f1 can be obtained by this one, f x0 plus h y1. X0 plus is already given to you, y1 you have obtained by predictor formula. So we will use this y1 to get the value of f1, corresponding value of f1, which is same as basically f1p predictor formula. Next, substitute obtained f1 in NBIF to get this one. So fx, fy, basically f1 plus n nabla f1 plus n plus 2 nabla square f1. So just notice the difference here, instead of f0 now I am focusing on f1, right? So this is my Newton's backward interpolation formula evaluated at f1. Now what is f1? That I have obtained from this one, fine. So I can use this one, equation number 2. Let me show you that equation number 2. So this was the equation number 2, and here I am using that one to get this one, this expression. Okay, so y1 is equal to y0 plus integration x0 to x1 f1 plus nabla f1. Directly I am writing this NBIF here. Now put x is equal to x1 plus n. So again, this terminology is very straightforward. So you can remember this notation, that while working with such kind of methods, you can directly take such kind of substitutions. Like here I am using x equal to x1 plus nh, which leads me the relation between dx and dn, that is dx equal to hdn. When you substitute x equal to x0, you will have n is equal to minus 1, right? And similarly, if you substitute x equal to x1, you will get n is equal to 0. Okay, now next is, Once you have taken this substitution, you can simply substitute here in your integral part, and what you will get finally, y1 equal to y0 plus h into this one, 1 half nabla f1 minus 1 by 12 nabla square f1 minus this, and so on. Okay, now neglecting again fourth and higher order differences, and expressing nabla f1, nabla square f1, nabla cube f1 in terms of functional values. So again, be careful about this one. Now you have moved further one step. Instead of f0, you have taken f1. So basically, this is nothing but a difference between f1 and f2. Okay. So in this way, you have to think over it regarding all these values. Substitute here, and then you will have the final form, which is your equation number 4, which is also known as Adams-Moulton corrector formula. So y1 is equal to y1 corrector, which is y0 plus h by 24, 9f1 plus 19f0 minus 5 f minus 1 plus f minus 2. So here you have moved further. First is f0, then this is f1, f minus 1 and f minus 2. So this is your corrector formula. And so now we have deduced both Adams Bashforth predictor formula and Adams Moulton corrector formula. Now you can even improvise this thing. You can have an improved value F1C here. So you can simply back substitute this in your corrector formula, in this formula again. Now you can use here the corrected version, that is F1C, and you can get a still better value Y1. So basically you can have the repeated values here. You can substitute here F1, then F1C, then again corrected value, again corrected value, and then your Y1 will be more and more refined. So this is the basically the idea. Okay. Now sometimes this method is simply known as Adams method to avoid any confusion. So even in exam, if it is just asked that apply Adams Bashforth method, then it means that you have to work with both the formulae, predictor and corrector. So basically you are dealing with AB and AM, both methods. Okay, they are not methods, basically they are formulae. So the AB formula, that is Adams Bashforth predictor formula, and Adams Moulton corrector formula, together this will give you original method called Adams Bashforth method, or normally Adams method, right? So I hope with this you shouldn't have any confusion in the title of the method or the application of the method, I mean the derivation of the method. Okay, one more thing, this method is most effective when earlier approximations or solutions are generated through RK method. So whenever you see this method is nothing but a natural extension to find a better result for RK methods or some other methods as well, but for RK method it will give you most effective answers. Okay, now let's foster the concept by solving this problem. Here you are given dy by dx equal to x square into bracket 1 plus y, and you are given these four values y1, y1.1, y at 1.2 and y at 1.3. so basically four approximations are given to you, and you are asked to find the next one, that is this one. So y at 1.4, by Adams Bashforth method. Okay, so now let's see that how to implement this method to solve this differential equation. Okay, so let's note it down first. Fxy is x square into bracket 1 plus y. Starting values of the Adams Bashforth method is 0.1 here, and hence you can prepare a small table where xi values are there, yi values are there, and calculated fi values are also there. So x minus 3 is 1.0, y minus 3 is 1. So basically I am just denoting this as x minus 3 and this as y minus 3. So corresponding functional value, that this dy by dx is nothing but fxy, that I have written here. So corresponding value is x square into bracket 1 plus y, x is 1.0 here, and 1 plus y is again 1.000. so your final output is 2.000. okay, next is you have to find the second value, that is f minus 2. So what is it? X minus 2 is given, that is 1.1, this is also given to you, 1.233, this is also given to you, and corresponding f minus 2 will be 2.702, and similarly for other values as well, right? So once you finish with the table, you can use the predictor formula. We recall that predictor formula is given by this y1p equal to y0 plus h by 24 55 f0 minus 59 f minus 1 plus 37 f minus 2 and minus 9 f minus 3. You have to recall this formula. So just finish 4 or 5 problems and you need to remember, you can easily remember this formula. Okay, now x1 is 1.4, corresponding y1 predicted value from this one is 2.573. once you obtain these two values, you can always find f1p, which is 7.004, right? So you have finished the predictor part. Now using the corrector formula, y1c is equal to y0 plus h by 24 9f1p plus 19f0 minus 5f minus 1 plus f minus 2. So simply remember this formula, simplify this by using all these respective values, and you will get 2.575 as your answer, which is your corrected value. You may recalculate again y1 c1, that is more corrected value based upon this initial corrected value, and hence you can get more refined result. So basically you can use this result here. This is my y1c, corresponding f1c will be there, and then again use that f1c here. You can substitute here to get more refined result. That was the idea basically. So thus we have obtained y at 1.4 is equal to 2.575, which is the required answer, and we have finished Adams Bashford method. So let's recall that what are the steps that we have followed. Basically you are given one differential equation and with initial values. So basically it's an initial value problem, initial values. Okay, what other things are given to you? You will be given four approximations, and if these approximations are not given, then you need to find it out. You have to find by applying RK method. Okay, once you have this, you can directly use the predictor formula first, that is AB formula, and once you have predicted value, then you can use Adams-Moulton corrector formula. So apply these two, and then once you entered into this stage, you can refine this result again and again by using F1 corrector formula. Now let's work out rigorously the self-practice problems to digest the method completely. I have also make you understood that what are the main steps that you need to follow. You need to be careful while working with Adams Bashford method. And here is the list. Just pause the video, work out these problems, and try to verify whether you are getting this as your answer or not in both the cases. So basically here one of the differential equations is given in this way. You need to apply first of all RK method to find the one is already there, so you have to find other three approximations. Together with this you have now four approximations, and after that you can find this value. Just make a note here that you need to work out the value of y at 0.4. So basically you need to have four steps here. So y at 0 is given, you can consider step size 0.1, and then you will have 0.1, then 0.2, 0.3. So evaluate the y values at all these three points, 0.1, 0.2 and 0.3, and then you will be in a position to apply directly the predictor formula and then corrector formula. What about the second problem? In this problem, you are given dy by dx is equal to 1 upon x square minus y by x in this way. Now you are given here these all four values directly. So use these four values in order to find the next value, that is y at 1.4. So again, this is quite easy problem for you. Already you are given these four approximations, and hence half of the work is done. Simply you need to put these values in predictor formula. So friends, here you need to recall, or you can say you need to remember these two formula very well. The first one, that is Adams-Bashford predictor formula, and the second one is Adams-Moulton corrector formula. Once you know these two formula very well, then there shouldn't be any problem in solving such initial value problems. So I hope you have understood very well, and you can do a good practice on these problems and even some more problems based upon this method. So with this, I wish you a good luck in practicing these methods. Thank you very much.